Oh, yeah.
So, when I was here, it was actually about 15 years ago. And around that time, I guess, sort of considered myself a bit of a dropout. It sort of felt like a place where all the dropouts went. A bit of a, I guess, weird. All the people that went to this school were amazingly successful because they thought outside the square. Because they were very different. They looked at life in a very different perspective. So we all know to survive. And in my professional life, basically, I sort of study survival for a living. So I sort of got the perfect day job. My work basically revolves around challenges anywhere from Australia, the Arctic Circle, in the Amazon, in the Arctic, as I already said, in India, Southeast Asia. Sort of basically either traveling across the Amazon, so I've done about 14,000 kilometers to the Amazon by boat, across the Andes four times. What else? Been jailed down in Terra del Fuego, that's pretty interesting. Can't talk about all of those here. So basically, I'm doing the things that I love. I'm chasing my passions and my dreams. And I mostly do things by first-hand experiences. So usually it's much easier for me to learn from mistakes because I'm a very bad mentor. So I find it very difficult to read instruction manual, all that sort of stuff. Everything I do hands-on. And that's actually why I went so well at this school. I used to go, but it was here that I learned a bit more from what I was dealing with, and I was given the authority to grow up and to do something for myself and make my own decisions. It was also here that I found like-minded people who inspired me, who I felt comfortable with and who I could associate with. And it was here that I guess I found my path and life became very, very different. So, I mean, we live in a world these days with a lot of choices and a lot of opportunities. There's walls that, I guess, blown in with, you know, the internet and mobile phones and Facebook, and this constant stimulation. It's very hard to, I guess, navigate your way through life. But I guess the last 15 years have helped me recognize that it's very important to understand your capabilities. It's very important to assert your beliefs and stop chasing your tail and instead follow your heart and do what you actually genuinely believe is the right thing to do. Because your heart usually knows what's good for you. So surviving is about sharing your soul, opening your mind, removing your blinkers, and pursuing what you believe in, and also helping others to learn from your mistakes. That you're not necessarily going to want to do any of these things, and no one can necessarily force you to do any of these things. But everyone makes their own choices, and they do what they want to do in their own time. So hopefully some of the things I'll share with you will help you with some tools for the next year to sort of deal with the situation that's coming up. Is anyone a bit stressed out about the next year? A little bit?
Yeah.
Okay. It really doesn't matter that much. Yeah. It's funny, 15 years later, it was very important for me when I was in school. I guess in hindsight, I was really worried about what marks I'd get and how well I'd go compared to my peers. But in the end, the only person you're really competing against is yourself. So it makes sense to do or follow exactly what you want to do rather than what someone else tells you to do. Just do what feels right for you in that time and you'll probably be okay. So I mean, it makes sense that I'm going to give you some guidelines for next year. But admittedly, the world's going to make it end next year, so it doesn't really make much of a difference. So how do you survive in your own world? How do you survive at home? How do you survive at work? How do you survive a breakup with a boyfriend or a girlfriend? What can you do to better deal with those circumstances? So, everyone has very different situations and circumstances. I mean, in my world, I guess, my focus is on survival. So, when it comes to dealing with difficult situations, I've chipped a bone in my neck, I've broken a few bits here and have many stitches, also broken my jaw. What else have I done? I've been concussed a few times. Broken my foot, broken my thumb, dislocated my thumb, broken my arm. I've had yardia, dysentery, amoebas, parasites running through my veins, and dengue fever. I was stuck there on the side of the road having to deal with this circumstance, and I didn't really know what to do or how to do it. I never obviously had a dislocated finger, with no one to help me. So I realised that the only person who could help me was myself in that circumstance. So I decided to pull up my glove, and I got a really good hold, and has anyone ever seen Lethal Weapon? Yeah. Yeah. Mel Gibson like slammed his shoulder back in. Oh. I was like channeling Mel Gibson. I was like, it's gonna work, it's gonna work. It's like I thought this was the moment that I decided whether a man or a mouse. So, you know, this is my ultimate time, you know, to prove to myself that I was capable. So I grabbed a hold of it, it was still sitting back that way. So I had to pull it off and I slowly pulled it around and I let go. But ultimately, the only person who can change or make a change is you. Because nobody else is going to actually make that change in your life other than yourself. There's a very interesting quote by a guy called Dr. Norman Vincent Peale. And he said, the more problems you've got, the more life you've got. If you've got no problems, you've got no life. So in some ways, you know, if you've got this really boring, narrow, comfortable, you know, environment where nothing really goes wrong, it's not really that exciting or stimulating. But if things do go wrong, there's a lot you can learn and a lot you can apply from those circumstances that will help you in the rest of your life. Bradfield, in 1996, okay, so around that time you guys were like, what, 1 or 2 years old?
3.
About 7.
2, 4, there you go. Supposedly by that stage I finished my education, but there's still a long way to go after that. But since then, I've constantly chased my dreams because they make me happy. Sometimes I'm sleeping in a tent, sometimes in a hammock, sometimes in a slum, sometimes in a jungle, sometimes in a mansion, sometimes in a palace. All different circumstances. Sometimes food has been very abundant. So sometimes I've had anything I want all the time. Sometimes I've had one meal a day. Sometimes I've had no meals a day. But it's okay. Sometimes I've been the happiest person in the world, by far. And other times, I've been quite convinced that I'm the most unhappy person in the universe. I'm still pretty unsure of exactly what my purpose is, but I'm getting closer. Now, some of you may already know what your purpose is, and some of you may never actually work it out. But regardless, you may as well enjoy the ride in the meantime. So it's very difficult to find that inner compass that tells you what your dream is. As far as how to find that, I really have no idea how you're going to find that for yourself. That's something that you have to work out. But many of you are much closer than you realize. And you have to keep on going. You have to ask the questions that are important in your life and ensure that you persist. The same as the next week I'm going to be having in the Pilbara, I can't just stop and give up because the results will be disastrous. I'll probably die, so that was a suck. But you understand what I'm saying. So it's very important that you keep on trucking. Now, if it wasn't for Bradfield, I may not have taken this journey that I've taken over the last 10 years of my life. It was at this school that I was given the chance and the authority to grow up and do what I believed in, and I've stayed up ever since. So I'm very thankful to have the opportunity to talk with you guys and share this experience, and I hope that it will help you or inspire you over your next and final year.